Hello fellow stackers and welcome again. Now today I want to show you a few things that came the past few days at home, some through mail and some that I got myself. Now first of all, I got some new coins. I got some new silver. Let's check. I'm sorry I didn't do an unbox, but I got them some from international dealers and some from a local coin shop. So today is a mixed with all those things. And here we are. So again, these are not all mine. These are for me and a friend of mine. Now let's see first of all what my friend got. He got his first Philharmoniker. And he's new as me to stacking. And we talked and we realized that those coins have the less premiums in Europe than everybody else. So here is the first of his Philharmoniker. And it's a really, really beautiful coin. Now, the second thing he got, he actually felt a little bit jealous from me from the past episode that I did that unboxing from European Mint. And he got two of these, two Kookaburras that I personally love. And he seems to become a fan also of those things. And they are great. They came from European Mint. And after that, I got myself another Kookaburra. That's the 2019. Which I didn't have. My first Kookaburra was the 2020, the first one that I bought like this. And I also got a Britannia. Now that's a special edition, or I think not, maybe not, but it said that it has the oriental border. Now being from Greece, I know geometrical patterns like these, and I really do love them, and I really do love to see them in foreign coins, not only in Greek ones. And anyway, that's a new Britannia in my collection. I've got my first koala, a 2017, which came in a very nice condition and in capsule and everything, and I really love them. The second one is my other koala. That's the 2018 koala from Perth Mint, Australia. I really love them. And I'm just wondering how many of these animals have actually survived from those bushfires today and how many not. But anyway, this is a really beautiful coin. I love them. And my first ever American silver eagle. See, here it is. Here is my first American silver eagle ever. Let me get it closer. See if I can focus. Yeah, here you are. It's a 2019 American silver eagle. And really, guys, until I hold one of these coins on my hand, I really couldn't understand why the fellows from United States were so crazy about collecting these things and stacking them. But now I can see it's a really beautiful coin, and it's a pretty much standard for every stacker or collector to have at least one of these at his collection or stack or whatever. Because don't forget, I'm not a pure stacker, I'm also a collector. Now, these are what I got, and mine and my friends, but I paid a visit to my local coin shop, which I've been dealing with them and taking stuff from them, coins or commemoratives or different things, the past 3 or 4 years. So they know me very well. They know what I like, what I don't like. We talk about silver and gold prices and bullion or not bullion, the collectibles and not the collectibles, you know. Everything that a collector jumping to stacking might need to ask and learn and everything. But as I said, as a collector, I wanted somewhere to have my coins. For me, it doesn't matter if these are bullion coins. I really love them and I want them to be well preserved. And I want them to look nice whenever I show my coins to my wife or to a very close relative or to somebody that I trust, or even for my own personal, you know, view. I don't get it. If you are going to have, let's say, 200 coins that are different to each other, I don't say you've got 200 of these beautiful Philharmonikers or the Liberty Lady here. But if you've got, let's say, pandas and koalas and kookaburras and everything, then you need for yourself to watch out your collection. You need to see it and be preserved. And that's why I went to my coin shop, my local coin shop. And I got this beautiful, beautiful wooden case, which I really love, with three trays inside that I can put these coin holders with all my coins and be saved well and be preserved and be great to showcase them. So at my coin shop, they made me a present and they said, do not open the box until you arrive home so you can see what's inside from us. Now I've already opened it and I want to show you what was in there. No, it was not all these. It was just this one. You know? Some mints around the world like to put out some commemorative, not coins, tokens mostly, for people who work with them or for dealers or for anybody else. I didn't know they actually existed. And because the past 2 weeks there was the money fair on Berlin and my local coin dealer has been there, the Greek Mint has given him some of those tokens from 2020 for the welcome of the new year. And he actually put one of these inside that case for me as a present, and I really like it and I thank him a lot for that. It's not something expensive, it's not gold or silver or whatever, but it is a really nice piece of metal that I really love, and it gives me back a lot of memories, especially with this face on it. Because you see, that was the face of Pericles, and it was on the Greek 20 drachma coins until we actually got in the Eurozone. Until we got in the Eurozone, that was the front of the 20 drachma coin. Now, on the other side, it has an image of the Bank of Greece, a very beautiful building in the center of Athens and everything, and it says Bank of Greece Mint and everything. And here is the logo of the Mint of and the Bank of Greece and the Mint, the Greek Mint. And I thank him very, very, very much for that. Now, not only these, but you see here, it is three accessory trays, 1, 2, and 3, that I've already put some of my silver inside, and right now I'm gonna put some more. Firstly, I've put my pandas, and that front row will be only for pandas. You see that I'm still missing two of them from the past decade, because that one is from 2010 and that's from 2020, and I want to make a full line of these, so I'm missing two pandas. And underneath I've got a Britannia and Germania also, and then that Royal Arms coin that I really loved, that I got from my last order from European Mint, and it is a beautiful coin. I really love it. And some of the Chinese calendar coins, the pig or the rat here, you know, and everything. And Down here I've got my first kookaburra. So let me actually put my second kookaburra here. So here it is, the 2019 kookaburra. And it's getting in its rightful place. There you go, 2020, 2019. Hopefully in the next few days that some more will come. And then the Britannia with the oriental border, it goes right next to the other Britannia that I already have. And I also have two koalas, the 2018 and the 2017. For now, I think I will put them up here for now, until I got a few more of these also, koalas and kookaburras, that I can start their own accessory tray like the pandas here. And underneath, I've got my queen's beasts, of course, the 2 ounces. The only thing that I don't know and I haven't found yet is that I didn't find any coin capsules like this that can hold 2 ounce coins, you know, for all of them. So I've got the Lion of Mortimer, I've got the Falcon of Plantagenets, and I've got 2 of the Yale of Beaufort, really nice coins with a lot of milk spots. I hate milk spots, especially on Queen's Beasts. I really don't know how to get rid of them. And if, yeah, anyway, somebody told me in a previous video comment about e-zest, but in Europe we don't have e-zest, so I'm trying to find something that's in Europe similar to that. And then I've got also 2 of the unicorns of Scotland here, and then some other bullion here, like a Krugerrand or a kangaroo, and a Philharmonic here, you know. And my first ever Liberty Lady. That's my first one. And I really like it. I mean, it's a beautiful coin. It's a symbol, actually. I can understand all of you, my American friends, who love so much the Lady Liberty. I really do. It's a beautiful coin. Good for you guys. And then last but not least, I will put here my friends until he comes to get them. So what I want to say is, because there are so many big bullion dealers, don't stop going to your local coin shop, because sometimes they might have some surprises for you, you know, a new coin or some older coin which is used and it's heavily used and they've got it on a very special price or whatever. And it's like having a personal coin friend, because they know what you like, what you don't like, things that you might be interested in. Like, they knew that I'm also a collector and they've given me one of these, which is, I don't know if you can put a value on this thing, but it's a nice piece for my collection because it comes from their heart. I mean, they've got 10 of these and they've given me one of them, and I really love it because I don't know. You know, sometimes the gesture is all that is needed and not something of gold or silver or whatever. It means that they care about you, they know you. And also they've got cool stuff like this case, which I do love. I mean, I do love it. No, look at that. It's a fat, big case that I love. Anyway, if you liked that video, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe, comment, and until next time, keep stacking!